Now I'd like to talk a bit about brushes and basic brushes that you should have in your arsenal. This is a wash brush that you would use for doing wet on wet. It would be more or less restricted to the larger paintings. Well, full-size paintings, 22 by 30 would be fine, or even my 40 by 60 paintings, I quite frequently would use this width of a wash brush. These are watercolor brushes. See how soft they are? They are able to hold a load of water as opposed to an oil painting brush, which does not hold water to the same extent. So it's able to absorb, and you can use that to wash over a large area. Here's a favorite of mine. It's a little shorter bristle, but it's very capable of holding a lot of water, and you use it to cover wide areas. Another one I will use on a very small painting is a soft bristle, large fan brush. And I use that as a wash brush sometimes if I want to be more controlling, or I have an area in which I want more control. And I will demonstrate the use of that later. The fan brushes for oils, I usually have one approximately this size. And I will trim it. I will round it with scissors, like so, trim the edge, and get rid of the excess length at the end, because it gives you more control when you're using it vertically than having that thing. This is one of my brushes that is one of my favorite brushes. Well used, as you can see. Looks like something the cat dragged in, but it has a really good purpose, and I've used it over and over again, and I'll demonstrate that to you a little later as well. It's good to have a variety of round brushes. They come in different numbers, starting at 1, which is quite small. This is a number 4, and this is a number 6, and this is an 8, for example. As you can see that the brushes have different widths. So round, 1 or 2 flat brushes wouldn't go amiss. And if I can find one here, this is a plastic handle, so it's totally something you could leave in the water for a little bit longer, but you don't want to leave watercolor brushes in water for any length of time, because where the handle joins the rest of it, it will separate, the glue will separate if you leave it over too much time. So other than that, we use some medium fan brushes do have, and I'll explain later on when we're doing things like clouds, when those come in. You will want a very fine brush for painting very fine lines. And besides that, I use painting knives for painting with watercolors. They come in different sizes and shapes, and I use them for applying liquid mask, and also to create a texture in rocks and things like that. A toothbrush. An old toothbrush that you have kicking around. It's got a fairly stiff bristle. You want a stiff bristled one, because there are some tricks that you can use to incorporate with a toothbrush. So it's good to have that. You don't think of that very often. And so I think that's basically what you want to have as a brush. You can use the foam brushes and things like that you buy at a lumber yard, but those brushes don't have the absorbency to carry a load of water, so I don't recommend them. Here's a brush that you'd buy at a paint store. It's for water-based paints, but again, you're not going to have any ability to retain the water as opposed to the soft, hairy brush that is in which all the many more hairs, much closer together and much softer. A trailing brush would be the last thing. That's one of these. It's a long brush, and you use it to make fine lines where you want to put branches on trees and things like that. And I think that's pretty well it for brushes. A basic brush set to start will get you going, and you don't have to spend a lot. Just make sure that you have a variety of brushes and experiment with them.